Holiday to love family. We have messages for the Capricorns, Tauruses, and the Virgos. And the way that we're doing it today is we've broken it down where you all have your own separated messages. And so if someone would be just so gracious to timestamp when the signs come in, you may want to listen to all of them. Something may resonate with you for some of the other signs, depending on if you know sun, moon, rising, you know, could be in other earth signs. At the end, we're going to do a bonus. You're going to ask a question, so you can think about question. We'll be able to give you like a time frame, whatever the case may be, anything to be able to give you some answers. And then we're going to also do a healing activation towards the end as well, and do a couple of collective messages. These are messages of what you need to know right now. We're going to clear the energies and raise the vibrations. We're clearing the energies and raising the vibrations. We're clearing the energies and raising the vibrations. Any type of negative low vibration energies that you come here with is immediately being removed. Instantly. That is not welcomed here on this channel. We do not give permission. We do not allow no negative low toxic energy. And so it is, and so it is, and so it is. With that, we're starting with Capricorn, and then we're going to go with the Tauruses, and then we're going to go with the Virgos. So Capricorn, coming out, we have Queen of Air. Come through. Maybe that clarion did that. Beautiful energy. This is our new year, the spring equinox, okay? Queen of Air is coming through, all right? That's brilliant, experienced, you know, Queen of Swords. She don't play, all right? She's cutting out everything that is not for her highest and greatest good. She's focused. She's paying attention. She's grounded. She's rooted. All right? So therefore, that is beautiful energy for you to be in right now. We have be in service and empowerment. And this is coming from the nature spirits. So now is a time for you to be in the service of others. All right? So while you're in this strong energy, cutting everything out, you're getting focused, you're getting information, you're grounded, you're rooted. You know, you want to connect with nature. You want to get the messages from the spirit animals, right? You want to get the messages from the trees, the plants. They're speaking to you right now. So now it's time for you to do those things of service. Be of service, all right? Open yourself up to help others in need. If you have a channel or something, or do something that can help raise the frequency of this planet, do so. This is the time now. We have empowerment. Some of you are meant to empower others and the people around you. This is your time. All right. Some of you are feeling empowered. Some of you this is a new beginning. So congratulations. And you've made it so far. So we want to congratulate you. That is amazing. Right. So now you're opening yourself up to this energy of being more powerful, being more grounded, more rooted, focused on what matters. You're not going back and forth with nobody. You're not allowing all these material things to take you over because you recognize it means nothing. It means nothing. What matters is how you feel and how you are to others and everybody, you know, around you, and making sure that you are creating a place of peace and harmony and wholeness and trust. Okay. We have higher consciousness. And we're gonna let you know too that we completely like always detox our body. And because we want to make sure that we're giving you information from the higher realms that is nowhere near part of this matrix. So that you're getting direct uploads and downloads from higher realms. So, you know, we're purging right now. It is what it is. So it's going to be purging, maybe coming out of my eyes and out my nose, whatever it is. It is what it is. The toxins has to come out of the body. All right. We have higher consciousness. Wow. Some of you are really opening yourself up to the higher consciousness now. You're back online, right? Because you've been eating what you're supposed to be eating. You've been staying on the higher frequencies. You've been releasing what no longer serves you. You're not following the masses. You're being in your own individuality. You're not worried about what everybody else going on. You're not giving into all those things that everybody else is giving to. You are respecting and honoring yourself. You're putting yourself first. Congratulations, Capricorns. That is phenomenal. This is beautiful energy to be in this time. And it's such an honor. And we are so grateful because it's amazing to be able to read this type of energy. It is a blessing. higher consciousness. You have the higher realms that is coming in to guide and protect you. So pay very close attention to the signs. We have our inner calling. Some of you are getting that call. Answer that call from your gut, your first brain. Answer that call. They're reaching out to you. They're giving you signs and signals and everything. They're letting you know. Trust how you feel. Ground yourself. You know what's up. You know who you're supposed to be with. You know when to be alone. You know what's up, right? And we always like to let you know, too, we have been posting a lot of videos and information on our community tab. And then also in the description box below, you will be able to find some very massive, infinite wisdom information that will be able to continue to assist you on your journey. It is very imperative and important to keep up on these higher frequencies so that you'll be aware of what's going on. Because some of you may not realize that you're up here hanging around with NPCs, which is soulless entities, and some with souls, but their only reason is to distract you and to take you off of your path. So that could be why some of you may have been arguing back and forth with people, or always feeling like kind of held down, or whatever the case may be. You're not around your true tribe. You've been around all these false beings that was never meant to be around you. And this is family members and friends, work people, all of that. So watch those videos so that you can get a more understanding about that. But there's higher knowledge, higher wisdom. You tapped in, tuned in. You're online now. The higher realms is contacting you right now, Capricorn. So it's time to get in the line. It's contacting all you all, everybody. Then we have comfort. So the angels want to bring you comfort during this time. They don't want you to be hard on yourself during this time. They want you to do what you do best. It's go into nature. Go be in nature and ground yourself. Be very focused. Be very aware. Because there's a lot of things that are, you know, being manipulated and everything that wants to try to keep you off of your path and distraction. You're going to have to be strong. You're going to have to be really strong during this time to not give in to anything, to any cravings of like processed foods, sugars, things that you know that you're not supposed to be doing. You have to continue to just go straight. You have to. I'm telling you, and in fact, those videos, if you watch those videos on the community tab or inside the description box below, and you could get the description box by clicking like the title, I believe, or something, you'll see the information. It'll open up for you for those who don't know. But having access to that wisdom will make you be like, oh no, I'm not doing no, and I'm saying no. You will see why you need to say no and why it's a complete sentence. You will see why you have been wasting your time and energy for years, being stuck in a loop, being stuck in a toxic cycle. And now you woke. You're online. Again, we want to congratulate you. You've come a very long way. And we are very proud of how far you've come. We have dragon coming out for you. Whoo, that dragon energy. That's very powerful now, Capricorn, that you got the dragon coming out, which is passion. The dragon is a reminder of your strong will and your fiery personality. It is also a symbol of passion and fire. You are being asked to practice self-control and be cautious so that your passion does not lead you into trouble. So you have to stay focused. You can feel the fire in your belly, but you have to stay focused. I'm telling you, you're going to have to do that homework and watch those videos so that you make sure that you are not giving your energy, time, and all your resources to soulless entities, to beings who are just meant to block your path, to steal your dreams, to make sure that it doesn't manifest, right? So pay attention. You have to stay focused. And then we have the swan energy coming out with love. It's so beautiful. So for some of you Capricorns, it says you have found your soulmate, or they are just around the corner. That is so beautiful. Love is so amazing. Can I sugarcoat that? So for some of you all who just met someone, that is definitely your soulmate. You can open your heart and trust that. For some of you who have not, you are online now. So now your soulmate can actually find you. You know, your light's been out for a long time. The bill hasn't been paid because you've been living in your head, wasting all your money, being all up in that head when you should have been in your gut and having your heart open. But now you know, so that's great. Remember that when two souls are destined to be together, they always find their way back to each other. All those things you had to go through were worth it. Congratulations. Oh, congratulations. Oh, you're the beautiful hummingbird. Ah. I'm so connected to the animals, and the hummingbird has been coming to me too, which is, and it signifies lightness, which is true, meaning, you know, you want to lighten your load. A lot of you all have way too much. You like shop too much. You got all this extra stuff and you don't need it. Give it away, donate it, do something. You don't need all this stuff. You want to travel light, because what's about to happen, you ain't gonna be able to take all that stuff with you. You're gonna need to be able to keep a small little amount of things with you so you can be ready to move and shake when it's time for you to move and shake, because things is about to get real. That's why it's important for you to have your focus. And you can't carry all that stuff with you. You have to be able to let go of all that, whether it's material things, whether it's emotions and people, situations, environments, whatever it is that you are clinging or attaching yourself to, you have to let go of attachments. You have to. So it is time for you to pursue your dreams with determination. By doing this, you will make them a reality. Joy is just around the corner, but you have to believe that it's possible to manifest your visions. So stop waiting and doubting. So when you have that, when you come from that lighter essence, meaning too, like when you're eating, make sure that you're eating food that's giving you information. Information comes from plants and fruits. You have to make sure that you are soaking your fruits and everything of that nature as well too, to ensure that the pesticides and toxins that were sprayed on them is off, okay? So therefore, make sure that you eat those lighter foods so that you can feel light and have energy to be able to prepare for with your visions and dreams, because right now you're in such beautiful energy that anything is possible. Anything can happen, anything. So that's why you want to focus on the good, speak the good, and all will be well. Beautiful. We have more animal messages for you here. We got the moose coming out with wisdom. So let your head and mind reach to the stars, past this dimension to higher realms. Yet keep your feet grounded on earth. Listen to the ancient wisdom in your soul. Listen to the ancient wisdom in your gut, your first brain. All right? The ancestors speak through you. You know much. Some of you are extremely wise souls. I'm over here speaking to some, you know, I was learning more about genetics and everything and blood types. And, you know, we discovered that if you are like an A blood type, positive or negative, you are strongly connected to the nature, like to trees, plants, and birds, like the animals. Like you're one of the people that likes to feed the animals or hug trees or be around trees and nature. Like that's you. You're an old soul. You're a wise soul. You've been here the longest. I believe that was that, or is it the Lyrians? But we're going to get into the star seeds. That's a whole nother thing. But right now, some of you all, you know, and I know that we attract star seeds because we're one. So therefore, we know that you are an old soul. You came to protect your land, to protect, and you know, you're really big on that, and protecting nature and things of that nature. There's so much wisdom inside of you to be activated and open, and now you're back online, so now it's activated. So keep doing it, keep hugging them trees, keep saving and protecting and loving and honoring nature and the trees, okay? Then we have the penguin. Authentic, reach out to your tribe in times of need. Family gives you strength when you face a storm. Love your uniqueness. You are full of surprises. Break free from others' expectations. Just be yourself. Break free from all those titles and roles that was projected onto you. That is not who you are, right? And a lot of this channeling information that you're receiving today, if you look at those videos, you will see exactly, you will know exactly, especially when it comes down to genetics and blood types. There's videos that break that down completely. You'll be like, oh. And you can put everything together. It's like a puzzle piece. Put all the pieces together so that you can know exactly what it is that you need to do. All right? But the thing is, you want to be your true authentic self. You don't want to be something because somebody else told you to be that, or you wear your hair that way because other people do. No, be you. Do you. Be authentic. Be your true authentic self. Okay? And then we have the Orca whale that came out with adventure. So dare to do things differently. Sing your wow song. Manifest your travel dreams. Attempt the great journey with confidence. Be loyal. Friends and family are your treasures. Be brave. You are more powerful than you know. It's very true. Just open yourself up. You have way more power than those inorganic ones. Because you're organic. You're organic. You don't have to conform to this whatever this is, right? You can leave, you can ascend. They can't, but you can. So stay focused, right? Stay focused. And when they talk about family, they talk about your soul family, okay? Because again, some of you all, that's what's gonna be very important to watch those videos. Some of you all incarnated to families that are NPCs. They're not even your actual family. They were meant to call, you know, like you have some children that can't stand their parents or something like that, or like the parents held them back, whatever the case may be. That was intentional. That NPC has a soul, but yet their only purpose was to make sure that you did not live out your purpose, that you was not creative, that you did not do the things that you want to do. You know, so again, you know, you go to the videos that's in the description box or on the community tab, then you will know. Then we have the cow. So give with unconditional love and grace, or infinite love and grace. We're gonna say infinite love and grace, because these words, some of these words too, it's just, it's, you know, we do the best we can with what we can, okay? Because a lot of things is backwards. A lot of things that you believe to be is not. So a lot of things is being revealed. So you wanna give infinite love and grace in all ways, all right? Now when we get down to our soul truth messages, we have name all the things that you love. All right, we're gonna give us some guidance now, so that you can stay on those high frequencies and vibrations. If you name all the things you love, were you number one on that list? Your mantra is, I give myself all the love and attention I need. If you was not number one on that list, and be honest with yourself, if you was not number one on that list, it's time for you to start engaging into self-love, because you come first. You matter. Lighten your load. Trust yourself. No is a complete sentence. You don't have to explain yourself to nobody, especially when you got about 8 billion people on this planet. You have 144,000 chosen ones, and that's also in the description box so that you can know if you're chosen or not. It's 144,000 chosen ones, which means they were sent here intentionally to raise the frequency of this planet, to bring the organic ones back to their natural, normal state, to wake them up. Now you're up, you're online. Congratulations again. But you got about 7 billion of NPCs and agents out here. So too many people are giving time and attention to that. It's time to break away. Am I consistently showing up? Some trade their dreams for comfort, yet comfort is the enemy of progress. Success requires showing up every single day, even when you don't feel like it, and even when it feels uncomfortable. It takes guts and endless vision to stay consistent to your dream. You got this. You got this. You were born ready. All right, my Capricorns, you can journal where you can be more consistent. This is your homework. Your homework is to watch those videos in the community tab and on the description box. And you're going to also make a note of all the things that you love. You're going to journal where you can be more consistent in your life with your soulful goals. And then show up. Don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. You look straight ahead. Don't let nobody take you off your path. All right? What else could this mean? Some of you are asking that. There are always multiple ways to look at every situation. Our first reaction is usually rooted in our fears and limited beliefs because of the programming that you had when you came here. Because when you know that our only one creator, and first of all, his name is not G-O-D. G-O-D is Satan. So anybody that's praying or believing and saying all this stuff, you're praising Satan, the one that's all into greed and all this just toxic, negative stuff. That is who you're praying to. So that is not. So if you're using that, then you know. And that's also, there's a video about that. Everything is literally backed up with receipts for those who need them. Because our only one creator is of love and of light, balance, and harmony. It's not to say things won't happen. Yeah, we have to challenge ourselves so we can become stronger. That's how we become strong. But you could grow through love. You don't have to grow through pain and suffering. All right? So you want to look at a situation today by stepping outside of the trigger and ask, what else could this mean? Is there something your soul is calling you to learn in this moment? Or is there a pattern that is ready to be broken? Walk in the other person's shoes and see it from their perspective. If it doesn't involve someone else, ask yourself, how is life happening for me right now? And that is usually an indicator of what is going on inside your womb. You know, what is going on with your soul. So meaning you have to pay more attention. You got to give yourself more love, especially for those who you was the number one on the list for the things that you love, things or people, whatever it is, right? Because the thing is to practice being the mirror as well. So for those of you who have been dealing with those negative NPCs, those soulless entities and beings, and you give all your energy, because that's what they want. This is what they want. They want you to go back and forth with them. They want you to feel that anger, all those negative ones. That fuels them. It makes them stronger because you're giving all of your organic, natural, loving energy away. That's why you ignore it. You remove it. You block it. You stop. You observe. You start being the mirror. Because for some of you, it may not be that easy for you starting out, but when you just recognize that somebody want to project some stuff to you, just like that time, you know, they're replaying something that happened where when I was driving, was going the wrong way, and the speed limit was 15, and I was doing 20, and I had to make a U-turn in the street because I was going the wrong way, and it was a car that came up on me about 50 miles per hour. It was honking, abruptly honking, extremely loud. And then when I turned, he said, "Hey, ho!" And I was just sending so much gratitude and grace, recognizing that I was an NPC because it was meant to trigger. All I know is I was keeping my focus on where I was going, and I was happy that I was going into the right direction. And that was also a beautiful indicator too, that I was going the wrong way. When you have that NPC coming behind you, that just shows you I was going the wrong way. I had to make a U-turn, right? So you can kind of use that as a situation. So you be the mirror, because that's not who you are. Can't nobody define you or tell you who you are. Only you can do that. It's what you believe. Where can I ask for more help in my life? Until we can receive with an open heart, we're never really given with an open heart. So when we attach judgment to receiving help, we knowingly or unknowingly attach judgment to giving help. So today's action is for you to ask someone for help and receive it with an open heart. And then your mantra is, "I ask for what I want and I'm open to receiving it." Because that's another thing too. For those of you who are followers of that so-called God, you've been following Satan for so long. That's what you've been praying and all that. All you have been bamboozled and just lied to and manipulated and controlled in so many ways. Because if you really recognize what those people represent too, which you will find out in those videos, you're going to be mind blown. But luckily you're online now, so all is well and all will forever be well. But the thing is, they have taught you to keep your heart closed. Your heart has to be open in order for things to just magically just appear and manifest. You can do anything. You can do anything and have anything that you want. And I'm telling you, money is nothing. Literally, it is nothing. Because there is a multitude of things that I have done and been able to go and travel all over the world and everything without having to use money. Now, the thing is, all of a sudden stuff, so what we mean by that, like stuff will be free, or they will continue to just keep giving you free stuff, or you know, something, there's some massive discount or something, and all of a sudden you get like these, it's just random, it happens. We don't question it. We are open, so we allow it, all right? So you want to open your heart and receive with an open heart, okay? How can I be more flexible right now? So what are you trying to control? Let love move through you today and trust that the outcome will be for your highest and greatest good. Remind yourself all day long that you are safe, that life is happening for you, and that you are not alone. And then do some type of activity, do some type of dance or yoga. You know, you always do the tree pose. They got some really easy poses and everything that you can do. And then we have, how can I surrender even more in this moment? These are some beautiful questions that your souls are asking us today. And we are very grateful to give you these lovely answers and guidance to be able to assist you along your journey so that you can continue to stay on these high vibrations, just fly high like the beautiful, wonderful beings that you are. Wow, we are so excited. It is essential to have clear, strong intentions of what we desire, but it's equally important for us to detach from the outcome. It's time to surrender. Let the universe have some breathing room to work. Let go of the will and trust so deeply that your trust turns into gratitude for what you cannot see yet, but you know it's coming. So it starts with your gut. You feel it. You just grateful, like you know that there will be justice. You know there will be harmony. You know there will be balance, right? You can feel it. And then you You will see it. Well, you'll know. Let's go. We're going to the gut. You feel it in the gut. That's how it activates. It's open. We open. We're so good. We're so loving. And then we get to our heart, our distribution center, because our heart is open. So I got to send those messages outside the dome. Send it out there because we are powerful. So we are activating it from our gut. And it gets to the heart. And then the heart goes, pew, straight out into the universe. Out past the dome. In the end comes the light that comes to, through your mind's eye where you can see. Because your heart, you know. In your gut, you can feel. And then there it is. Just like that. Oh, just like that. So know this. So deeply that your soul vibrates. You are not alone. Ever. Ever. There is millions that are surrounding me right now. Millions. You can feel them. You can taste them. And those that are open, you can see them. The plant kingdom, they're living. There's about 40 of them surrounding me right now, all over if I showed y'all. There's plants everywhere. They're living. These are beings. They are living bees. They're sending information. You're never alone. Your life has purpose. And the more you surrender, the more our only one creator can produce miracles in your life. You gotta let go. Be open to receive. Your mantra is today, I surrender. I accept all that I cannot change. I release the outcomes and I joyfully trust the process. And you know, we always be so hopeful and just know that, oh yeah, we'll be able to get one whole large video and break it down. So obviously we're not gonna need no timestamps because we're going to have to stop the video. It takes, you know, we're gonna manifest that it's just gonna lightning speed, just upload. The thing is, the longer that they are, you know, because we want to get these messages to you. So we're going to just leave it at the Capricorn. And we still got messages to go through. And then we're going to just break off the Virgo and Tauruses in a separate video. And the collective messages, you know, you can find the collective messages with, and the bonus with Virgo. Okay, because we just got to keep going while we're channeling. Because Capricorn, you had a lot of messages come out. All right. Am I getting enough rest to restore my energy and fully show up in my life? Great question. Thank you so much, Capricorn, for asking that question. If you're getting enough rest to fully show up, to stand tall and be brave and wise and rooted like the tallest tree because you come from them. Don't let them tear down no more of our trees. Don't let them hurt our babies, our family. That is our family. Those inorganic ones, for their paper, all of our wisdom is in us. We don't need no paper. You are the asset. You are the asset. This body is your vehicle. Notice how your body is feeling. How much sleep you are getting. And what you can do to help your body rest. Because you know. Who have you been praying to? And who are you listening to? Because our Creator will tell you to love. Our Creator will tell you to take breaks, to rest. The more you rest, the more things come together. The more you vibrate in harmony and love. Today, action, take a bath. If you can't take the bath, take the shower. Put on some lavender essential oil. Go to bed ridiculously early or give yourself a timeout today. Notice your body thanking you. Because this is a whole computer system. It's so magnificent. So many DNAs and codes. That's why it's important that you feed it right so that you can continue to activate. The plants give you information. so that it can upload into your body and send the messages out so that you can bring in what you need to bring in, right? You don't want to feed it death and process stuff. No. Your mantra is, the more I give myself permission to rest, the more I can contribute. You gotta rest. It's essential. It's essential. We have our goddess Queen Nandi coming through. Number 35, which is also an 8, infinite intuition. Your gut. Again, we got more messages to stay in that gut, right? Your intuition. You can trust it. You can believe in it and know that all is well and all will forever be well. It always has been. But you've been distracted. Everything is a distraction. Even from this video, we should have said in the beginning to put your phone or however you watch this on do not disturb, because there's always some type of commercial or ad. Somebody gonna call, the dog gonna bark, somebody gonna want something, somebody's going to want to stop you to break your connection from the video, right? So now we so grateful for that awareness that just came in. So now we're going to say that in the rest of our videos from the beginning as we clear the energies. But the queen is coming through with intuition, also wearing green. That is the heart, your heart chakra. So make sure that you keep that open. So great. We have whoever is looking for love. We got a new partner that came out. So just like with the other card with the swan. For those of you, if you've met someone and it feels like home, you can trust in them. You are online. That is your person. For some of you, you may have to... If your intuition is not on point, you are dealing with process things and you're negative and complaining, things like that, 9 times out of 10, that's an NPC. It's not. It feels like it, but it's not. And most times we always say to get yourself a personal so that we can just tap into just your energy to let you know. It don't hurt. It's best to know, especially when you're coming from someone who is in full alignment with our creator, to give you the guidance and the answers that you need to be able to assist you along your journey, right? A chance meeting is no mistake, is divinely orchestrated as a catalyst to set wheels in motion for the fruition of your prayers. Pay careful attention to new people we send into your life. You will recognize them by your sense of familiarity, comfort, and safety. You will know. You are wise. You know much. Ah, that is so beautiful. We got a few more messages, some mindful messages, and then we're going to get into a couple of angel numbers for those of you who are seeing repeated numbers so you can know what those messages mean. Now we have play, and it has the Rubik's Cube on here too. It is also the color green. So again, we signifying open that heart chakra, open and activate that heart chakra, okay? And as a matter of fact too, I will do the collective messages. As a matter of fact, yeah, we're going to do the collective messages too at the end of every reading so that you won't have to go to another reading to see or whatever. You need to be activated. So we have play. I am completely engaged in what I do in the here and now. Because remember, you want to stay in the here and now. You want to just focus and give all of your energy and attention into the here and now. I call it play instead of work. I am deeply fulfilled by all that I do. So for those of you all who are still a part of their program and they think that you have to go to these places to work, call that plane. I love doing this. I enjoy doing this. I enjoy doing what I love, until you can get yourself out of that loop and start doing what you truly do love and standing up for yourself. All right? Because a lot of you all are working for satanic beings. All right. And then we have commitment. I am committed to my growth and dreams. I set routines and habits that help me evolve into my fullest potential. Even though I may not see the physical manifestation of my desires, I know they have vibrationally manifested and are on their way to me. So you stand on that. That just goes back to that one of those soul truth messages that we've given you about. You feel it. Then you know, because you got your heart open. So you know your heart is open. So you know that you're going to receive it because your heart is open. That's why you know. And then when it gets up there to the mind, you're going so high that it is coming down from the higher realms. That is not a part of this dome. It is coming through, because nothing can stop the higher realms from coming, right? So that's how you receive your blessings. Have to have that heart open. All right, and then we have two angel numbers. 111. For those of you who have been saying 111, it is intuition. How many times have you heard me mention intuition? Which again is your gut, is your soul. Make sure you live there. That is your first brain. That is where you get all of your information to, because you want to trust how you feel. We are meant to feel. We are not meant to suppress emotions. We are not meant to hold grudges or anything of those natures. Again, like I said, a lot of you all have been following the Satans, all right? It's time for you to do something totally different, go a whole nother way. So 111 is moderation, it is patience, it is going with the flow, it is clarity, it is movement, self-realization, it is taking action, infinite love. Time to implement long-cherished ideas. You're on the right track toward making your dreams and visions a reality. The right people, circumstances, and resources are being sent your way. Happiness and new opportunities are at hand. So trust in the process, right? Trust in this, okay? So for those of you who are online and been doing the work, this is beautiful. You are starting to recognize this is a new year. This is spring. So it's all happening now. So you have to stay focused. Stay on those high frequency vibrations. Make sure that you're listening to 528 hertz, you know, music in up to 963 hertz. And also, too, do not limit yourself at all. Say that you operate in 6 dimensions through 12 dimensions. Always say you operate in higher dimensions, 6 through the 12th. Constantly say that. You operate in 6 through the 12th dimension. That is where you live. That is where you stay. You're here now. Yes, you're here now. And you're here in the 6 through the 12th dimension. Okay? Because we want to let you know that when they say you ascend into the 5th dimension, that is still a part of the matrix. You're not outside of it. Outside of it is 6th and beyond. So you want to start speaking existence, right? So that you can get yourself on up out of here. All right. Your activation today is going to be gratitude. And it's coming with the colors of pink, which is our source energy, our only one creator's energy. I am aware of the light in my life. I direct my thoughts to the beauty in and around me. I give thanks to our only one creator for every little thing that brings me joy. Thus, I enlighten my thoughts. Riches surround me, and I appreciate all that life brings. So stay in the essence of gratitude. It is far, but I'm just sending these frequencies to you right now. Sending the frequencies to you right now. The frequencies of gratitude. You are grateful for all, so that all good will come to you, so that all will be well. All right? All will be well. And then we have focus your mindset on what you can control instead of what you can't. The world is your oyster. So elevate your thought pattern so that you can attract abundance into your life. You are what you believe. And self-awareness is key. Self-awareness. You are to be aware of yourself. Nobody can tell you who you are or how to be or what you like and how you should do. No, only you know those things. And the way that you would know that is by going within and tuning into your energies, your inner being. Take time today to go within and spend time with your soul. Do that daily. Do that daily. Don't ever not spend time with your soul, or don't ever make decisions not feeling it from your gut and making sure that your heart is fully open. Because if your heart is not open and your gut, if you're not feeling it, you do not want to make a decision. Go for a walk in nature and ground yourself. Meditate. Listen to your favorite music that is 523 hertz and up to 963 hertz. Not no low frequencies. Do not listen to no low frequency music. It will reprogram you and put you back to sleep. You have to stay on high frequencies. Find you some new high vibe music. There are a lot of high vibing artists out there. You can do Tony Jones. You can do Londrell. You know, there's a lot of high vibing artists out there that you can listen to. And we also have some on our it's a playlist, and then Joy and Soul. But we are always available for you to contact us personally. We have, you know, there's a way to contact us, email, phone, or whatever the case may be. And that way you can get more information to be able to assist you. All right. And whatever you enjoy most, do that today. Do it. Or if you watch this video late, do it tomorrow. Okay. But you want to live this day fully. Okay. I don't want to shoot you out of your questions. We're going to do divine timing. So you can ask your question. We're going to do one question because this has been long enough. So ask a question surrounding time, even though we know that you're not supposed to be asking about time because you want to let things unfold naturally. But for some of you who really tapped in and tuned in, you may want to know if this is the time to do a certain thing, X, Y, and Z, or whatever case, or when something will happen. So whatever that question is, this will be your answer. We have no need to hurry. So not right now. Just continue being. Just continue to be. And all will be well. And it will forever be well. And we truly hope that you enjoy these messages, these frequencies, your high vibrations. Just know that you are fully open right now, because we don't play when it comes to clearing energies and raising vibrations. We are truly grateful. We are so in love with you. And we are thankful for all that you do. You beautiful, bright souls. You organic ones. You organic ones. We thank you. We honor you. We respect you for doing the work, for protecting nature, for protecting yourself, your family, your tribe, for heightening your awareness and your wisdom, going to do the work, the actual work, watching those videos to give yourself the information and wisdom that you need to help you along your journey. It's truly beautiful. All right, my loves. Till next time.